One is brand new, and the other is very nearly new. Today we're looking at the 2021 Ford Escape and the 2021 Nissan Rogue. The world loves compact crossovers right now, so let's see which of these two is the better buy. Let's start with the all-new Nissan. For 2021, the Rogue has been completely redesigned. It looks like a baby Pathfinder, and that's a good thing. For the Escape, Ford redesigned this CUV in 2020. It's still fresh looking, and the 2021 model year brings on new content in the options packages, including an available 10-way power adjustable driver seat, LED lighting, a hands-free liftgate, and more importantly, there's now a plug-in hybrid version arriving in the spring. On the outside, the Escape is a bit more anonymous than that Nissan. Some will appreciate that, while we prefer the slightly more appealing looks of the Rogue, which is a sentence we never thought we'd say, but Nissan really did a good job on the redesign here. Move inside and you'll find pleasing cabin spaces in both machines. With the Escape, you've got a surprisingly quiet ride. There's a lot of soundproofing work that's been done and it pays off here. Additionally, the front seats are comfortable, rear seat legroom is generous, and you can slide the rear seats forward to boost rear cargo space, though we don't love the amount of cheap-looking plastic you can see. Nissan, however, has taken a wonderful approach to its interiors. Almost like what Mazda is trying to do, Nissan has made the Rogue feel much nicer inside compared to the segment in which it competes. The cabin is quiet, comfortable, and well laid out. And Nissan's zero-gravity driver's seat means minimal fatigue on longer drives. As for power, Ford gets the edge here, no pun intended. The base engine on the Escape S is a 1.5-liter EcoBoost 3-cylinder engine. It makes an impressive 181 horsepower and 190 pound-feet of torque. There's a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder available as well, which makes 250 horsepower and 280 pound-feet of torque. Both pair with an 8-speed automatic, and both easily return over 30 miles per gallon on the highway, even with all-wheel drive, which comes standard on the 2-liter. Ford also offers a hybrid that pits an electric motor with a 2.5-liter 4-cylinder engine that returns a very impressive 40 miles per gallon in combined driving. Finally, a plug-in hybrid will arrive soon, and Ford says it should be good for 37 miles of pure electric driving range. With the Rogue, Nissan serves up one engine, one transmission, and two drive configurations. The Rogue gets a 2.5-liter 4-cylinder engine that makes 181 horsepower and 181 pound-feet of torque. It mates to a CVT and can be had with front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. Fuel economy is around 30 miles per gallon highway on the front driver and just under that on the all-wheel drive version. There is no hybrid, there is no forced induction. So the Nissan has better style and a nicer interior, but Ford has way better powertrain choices. But how much do they cost? Both the Escape and the Rogue start at just over $26,000. A top spec Escape Titanium, which comes standard with the hybrid engine, leather trim, a 10-speaker audio system, and much more, starts at $33,400. The top spec Nissan Rogue Platinum starts at $35,430 and gets semi-aniline leather, a 12.3-inch digital instrument cluster, 9-inch touchscreen, wireless charging, and more. This may be our closest battle yet, and it all depends on what you're looking for. The Nissan offers great exterior styling and a class above interior. The Ford has much better engine choices, and the upcoming plug-in hybrid will be an excellent choice in this segment. We can't fault you no matter which direction you go here. For us, we're going with the Ford Escape because of the powertrains, but anytime we see a 2021 Rogue at a stoplight, we'd be admiring its sheet metal.